50. I just stopped and set up some cameras. You really can't stop out here and get passed by a car without them asking you for help, which is really nice. It's, God, your face is just covered, and it's like a variety. It's not like the same type of bug. It's like sort of like
a red one and a green one.
Yellow, just really
smaller red.
Disgusting.
Yeah.
Nevada. Come for the desert, stay for the insect variety. Stay for the entomology.
Just lean forward a little bit, bike fell over, and we broke our backup lever. So
George is about to go buy two new brake levers.
Probably gonna buy like three clutch levers.
Three clutch levers, yeah.
Seriously, I mean, I'm not gonna stop dropping it.
We actually passed a Suzuki Yamaha place, I think, on the way in, and we're within walking distance, so we're gonna go check it out, which is, Harley makes it a fucking struggle. We roll in, he breaks it, and like, oh, I guess we'll have to walk to the store to buy a new one.
Yeah, a great conflict. Well, you know, we'll give it a chance. They may not have it.
Yeah.
And I don't know if you can see through there, but there's actually a bunch of pictures of motorcycles in there, which gives us the impression that this place is out of business. There's a car out front.
Just get in.
Who would have thought that, you know...
Ely doesn't have, you know, enough...
You know, yeah.
Hey! Sorry.
We were sort of prodding around, and I was trying to videotape to show there's a parts desk, and all of a sudden I changed focus. There's a woman right in front of us.
But, so she informed us that there was like a little motorcycle apparel store down the street, which may have it. I mean, brake and clutch levers get broken because they're like the first thing to break when riders drop their bikes, and all riders drop their bikes and brakes.
Have you ever broken a clutch lever? So I've broken like three in the last 2 months. We did buy two different clutch levers for dirt bikes that look to be approximately the same size. So we return. Hey, the guy said as soon as I break into it, you know, we bought it. So, I think the silver one will work. It looks closer.
I think we threw this away. That's the one you wanted? The thick one?
Yeah. It's too thick. Oh, you're kidding me.
Well, keep it in a pinch. We can use it.
Yeah. Bad gamble.
Neither one of these works. It's gonna be an expensive gamble. Could have bought a samurai sword.
Perfect.
And just
pull it. Just don't fucking drop it.
I can't promise that. Just drop. Bike dropper for life.
So Ian just dropped his bike. It's important to note that someone other than George drops their bike.
It's true.
Although the good news is, unlike George, Ian didn't break anything irreplaceable.
I was off the bike and it was on its kickstand, and I think I was fooling around back here and must have nudged it forward, so it just fell on the side, right on the stator cover.
Throwing on some cameras, looking glorious view out
all
here.
All for you, America.
Just after installing my sexy new clutch lever. Yeah, we went into a French expatriate, I guess. He's actually been in the U.S. longer than either of us have been like alive.
French expatriate, hash-smoking, artist who's currently working with wood, sometimes metal.
I don't know that we can, you know, hash smoking makes it sound like he was a bad guy.
No, he was cool. He offered us something.
But he lives in Santa Fe and offered us a place to stay there. So I'd like to stay with an artist, a French artist in Santa Fe.
Yeah, that's so sweet. So he had a 20-year-old daughter.
Who was not present, unfortunately.
Yeah, so we know he's not gay, despite his last name being Mark Gay. There's nothing wrong with that. I'd totally stay with, you know, a nice gay guy.
As long as, yeah. I mean, I'd stay with a straight or gay guy, as long as they didn't seem like a gay or straight rapist.
Sure, we reek of heterosexuality. I mean, just look at us.
Hopefully. Look at that tattoo. Anyway, well, we're going to get gear back up and film this road and then stop again in 5 more miles and then make it to the Grand Canyon by dark so we can show you more night footage.
Record what we can.
So, I have run out of gas in the middle of southwestern Utah. The bikes have not been getting great gas mileage at this elevation. Maybe instead of 40 like we're getting regularly, maybe 35 or something. So, you know, I said, well, we should keep our speeds down. And Ian pinned it at like 80 and disappeared. So I haven't seen him in about an hour. Hopefully he knows what he's doing and he makes it to town. I guess I should look a lot more scared. I just realized that, like, you know, I need to be pensive. I just don't know. I don't know if we're gonna make it. I don't know if we're gonna make it out here. Actually, instead of packing this up, I hear someone driving like an asshole. Let's see.
What happened, dude?
Shut the fuck up. You know what happened.
What happened?
We still have another 100 miles to the Grand Canyon, at least.
Oh, yeah.
So why don't we
go I would like
camp out here.
Really?
I mean, how far do you want to go? It's going to start getting fucking cold again as soon as it goes down.
As far as what?
What do you have to say for yourself?
Caffeine addiction. It's a bitch. Also, that I'm gonna reserve another map. Never had one before, dude.
Go ahead. So, we have found, looks like it's like an open range or something. Drove like a mile into the woods. We got in kind of early, so a little bit of daylight. It's pretty sandy, but we think we're secure. There's definitely loose cattle where we're camping, but they're down a ways, and I don't think they want to mess with us. I don't really know what cattle think motorcycles are. Chopped up a whole red bell pepper, and I don't have any cooking oil, but. Sauteing it down with that. Ian's busy like talking to women or something useless like that. So we're gonna have some chicken fettuccine, some cat food grade chicken, just like sort of a running theme, and some red peppers. It'll actually be a pretty classy meal.
All right, so George has prepared us a delicious bowl of gruel.
Like, so Ian.
It's hard to see.
Like, had the brilliant idea to like wax on the bikes. Bottle of liquor, so you know, I ate like, you know, a meal with like fresh vegetables and pasta and meat, and there's more than we could eat, so it's really difficult out here. It's like roughing it like crazy. I don't know if we'll survive.
Oh, like
a cowboy lifestyles.
Gosh, it's tough.
Yeah.